So I'll take it to the next question, because you answered the question I originally asked.
Okay.
So when did you decide to come out of the closet, if you will, this channeling closet? Because again, like I've said to so many channelers who come on the show, this clears a room. Yeah. So how did you deal with that?
Oh, well, to be honest, I'm not really out of the closet. Here I am, you know, I'm writing a book and I'm on your show and a couple of other shows, and I do a YouTube and a lot of recordings on podcasts. You know, I don't run around telling people what I do. It's really funny because they do let me know who I can share it with and who I can't. And sometimes the people that I think that I could share it with, and I've done it against their advice, and it hasn't turned out well. So, you know, I really don't go around looking to tell people. I just do my thing. And if they discover me, you know, they're probably maybe going to say something, or maybe they have and they haven't said something. And, you know, I just feel like it's been one of those things when they talk about a rise in consciousness where I just don't really think about it anymore or worry about it. And therefore, it doesn't seem to be a problem for me. And, you know, I have my family who I'm very close to, my two sons, my daughter-in-law. Mm-hmm. I have, you know, my husband, who's very open, a sister that works with me on a lot of my work stuff. So that's enough for me. And I don't feel a need to go. I don't want to change anyone's beliefs or try to jam something down somebody's fault that may not be in alignment with what their spiritual beliefs are. So I just let people find me that want to find me, and I don't try to sell myself to anyone outside of that, I guess.
Well, there'll be a few more people who are going to discover you after this conversation. I have a feeling. So, you said, would Athena in truth would like to come out and play, if you will, answer.
Oh yeah. Questions? She would like to come out and play. We know that, you know, that we are not shy. Yes. Robin is what is called a conscious channeler. And what is that really? Well, she doesn't really know exactly what it is that is being transmitted as we are talking, but we are ever present or always there. Why is that? The moment that we arrived, you did ask a question she didn't answer, by the way. How did she know we were there? We sat her up and breathed her body. She was a little surprised. She knew she was not the one that had drawn the breath. You see, we told her, if you want to feel confidence, this is what it feels like. This is the question that she had posed to us. She said, I am nearly 63 years old, but yet I still am not confident. What is it that I am missing? What is it that I could do to acquire that feeling of real confidence? And so as she felt us breathe her, as we sat up, and as she felt the presence of myself, Athena, she knew for the first time what it felt like to be a woman in her confidence. You see. What is it that we could speak with you today that would be of interest to you?
To watch the full video, click on the link below. And don't forget to subscribe.